Valley News Live, 10 at 10, continues with No Wait Weather.
All right, a look out to the west shows some high clouds overshooting the tops of some thunderstorms way, way out to the west for us. We remain quiet for now. Here is a look at the current conditions. It's 73 at the airport, light winds and perfect conditions across the region. Right now, 68 for you in Gwinner, 70 Langdon, 74 Devil's Lake, Grand Forks, 73 as well. And a lot of mid and upper 60s across northwestern Minnesota with a low 70s across Lakes Country at this 10 o'clock hour. Storms along the border north of Minot are scooting to the east, and they will continue to impact counties along the Canadian border. Don't expect severe from that. And these storms down here in southwest North Dakota, drought stricken, starting to lose some of their energy. We hope they get some rain. And actually, it'd be nice if some of that moisture would work its way towards us. Here's what your hour-by-hour forecast has to say about that. The activity up in Canada will continue to swirl along the border tonight. There'll be a chance of that continuing, I do believe. Although, like I said, I don't think severe. As we rise and shine, a few showers will be possible in our western counties, but I wouldn't bank on it, especially in our driest counties, Stutsman, Barnes, and Point South. Now, as we go through the morning hours tomorrow, you'll notice a big change. South winds and increasingly humid air throughout the afternoon. Look at the showers continuing along northwest Minnesota and towards Lake of the Woods as we go through the early hours. That's going to keep your temperatures at bay while the heat builds down to the south. Now, with all of the heat and all of the humidity, our atmosphere will be volatile, and because of that, we'll see a developing possibility of thunderstorms. Not everyone will see thunderstorms, not every location will see them, but any storms that form tomorrow because of the heat and the humidity that you see on the board here could very quickly become severe. Not only that, with our winds coming from the south across the surface and from the northwest and west across the upper air, there should be a lot of spinning in our atmosphere. So we could see a couple of tornadoes as we go through the afternoon and evening hours. Now, our model paints the best chance from the Devil's Lake Basin right through northwest Minnesota as we go between 4 and 11 o'clock at night with the storms continuing to work their way through. Does that mean it will remain quiet and dry down to the south? Not necessarily. Like I said, any storm that decides to form tomorrow could quickly blossom and become very strong. We'll keep you updated right here. Just keep your eyes on the skies, and if you start to hear rumbles of thunder anywhere you see in the yellow or orange tomorrow, which is our entire viewing area, the storms could be severe. Damaging hail over 3 inches, wind gusts over 70 miles per hour, and a couple tornadoes, not going to be out of the question. Fargo, warm to start. It's going to be even warmer to finish, near 90 gusty south winds. Best chance of storms in Fargo will be between 8 and 11 o'clock at night. Looks like the heat, desert-like heat for southeast North Dakota. Lakes Country, mid-80s. Lake of the Woods area, as we mentioned, cooler thanks to some ongoing midday shower and thunder shower activity. Well, you may see sights like this from southeast North Dakota tomorrow if you're looking to the north. A distant thunderhead east of Grafton. Eric, thanks for uploading that photo. Quieter, cooler weather as we go through most of Wednesday and Thursday. But after that, the heat is back into the region. Andrea, we'll see 90s to 100 degree weather likely across portions of south central and southeast North Dakota through the weekend ahead with only spotty shower chances. It's getting extremely dry. We really could use some rain here.
Here comes the heat.
Indeed.
Thanks, Hutch. Mm-hmm.